Hi, welcome to this introduction to the mixing window. To open up a new mixing window, simply click on the new mix icon located in the main toolbar. The mixing window allows you to mix different file types, such as audio, video, and photos, and you can save them, upload them to YouTube, or burn them to CD, DVD, and share them with the world. In this video, we're going to focus on making an audio mix. In part 2, we'll focus on making a video and photo slideshow mix. If you've used trakax before, you'll notice some new icons for added functionality. These are automatic crossfading, which allows you to crossfade files on the same channel. If you uncheck this button, files will just sit on top of each other with no crossfading taking place. To learn more about crossfading, please see the crossfading tutorial. The sticky nodes button. When turned on, all nodes on envelopes and effects will stick to the segment. If the segment is moved, all nodes will move with the segment. The snap to grid button. When the snap to grid button is enabled and a beat synced audio segment is adjusted in length, the segment will align itself with the nearest grid line. Also, if you create a selection or loop region, they will snap to the nearest grid line. To disable this feature, click on the icon to turn off. The auto selection button. Auto selection allows you to move and copy segments and/or large collections of media to different areas within the mixing window. And finally, the segment snapping button. This allows you to align segments exactly to media in channels above or below the segment. It also allows you to place media side by side with precision on the same channel with no overlapping. So let's now introduce some audio content. I'll simply drag and drop my loops into the mixing window. At the top of the mixing window, you'll notice the global tempo. This is defaulted to 120 BPM. This simply means all audio will play at 120 BPM. To adjust this tempo, simply use the tempo pot or highlight the tempo field and enter the tempo you'd like to use. To learn more about global tempo, please view the adjusting BPM videos. When you bring a piece of audio into the mixing window, the first thing you may notice is the track name and properties. In this section, you can change the parameters of your track. You have Enable Disable Beatsyncing. If you bring in a piece of audio into the mixing window and do not want it to be beatsynced to the global tempo, click on the beatsyncing icon to turn it off. You can also mute your audio, solo the track, you can insert volume and pan envelopes, and check and alter the BPM parameters of your audio. You can also alter the volume of the track using the volume slider, or boost the volume by right-clicking on the slider and selecting a new max volume from the drop-down menu. You can also adjust the pan for the track by adjusting the pan pot. You can also adjust the height of the track and minimize it. So now we'll move on to adjusting the length of your loops and moving them to other areas within the mixing window. To adjust the length, simply move your cursor to the start or end of the segment until the adjust length indicators appears. Click, and holding down the left button on your mouse, drag in the direction you wish to adjust. You can also paint a new segment into another area of the track. To move the file around the mixing window, click on it and highlight it, and move it around the mixing window. One of the new features we've added is the ability to snap segments, which allows for a precise placement of the segment. If I move my segment and place it beside the first segment, you'll notice it will snap to the first segment and a blue arrow will appear indicating it is placed directly beside it. If I move the segment further onto the first segment, it'll begin to crossfade. To turn automatic crossfading off, click on the crossfade icon. I can also snap and align my segments to other segments in the tracks, above and below it. Again, this is indicated by blue arrows in the top and bottom corners. To turn this function off, click on the segment snapping icon. You'll notice when you drag your segment, there are small indents at the end of the segment. This simply indicates that I'm at the end of the segment, and when I drag it, it'll be repeated. This is very helpful when lining up my media. If you have a segment which is disabled from Beatsyncing, we've provided an extra indicator to inform you that you've reached the beginning or end of the segment. These are indicated by the green loop graphic at the beginning and the red loop graphic for the end. Another new feature that we've added is using the scroll wheel on your mouse to zoom in and out of the mixing window. As you zoom in, more grid lines will appear, allowing you to do more intricate painting of segments. You can also use the zoom in and out buttons in the bottom right hand corner of the screen. So now I'll go ahead and open up a new mix to show you some of the playing options available. When I open a mix, I can press play and stop to control my mix. One of the new features we've introduced is being able to scrub through your audio and video using the play bar, which gives you greater flexibility when creating your mix. You can also grab the play bar to position it anywhere in the mixing window. You can also double click with the left mouse button to place the play bar in that specific position. The loop play button is situated beside the play button. This button is associated with the loop region bar and selection box. So now I'll set up a loop region. I can simply right click on the time bar and select loop start. Go to the area where you want your region to stop, right click and select loop stop. If I press play, you'll notice it'll only play the mix within this region. You can also adjust the length of the loop region with your mouse. A quick way to set up a loop region is to double click on the time bar with the left mouse button to add a loop start, and double click with the right mouse button to enter loop stop. If you'd like your loop region to extend to the whole mix, right click and select maximum loop size. You can also create a loop region and set a selection. Once a selection is created, you can copy or cut all media within that selection. You can also remove the loop region by selecting Remove Loop Region, or clicking on it and pressing Delete on your keyboard. You can also create a selection anywhere within the mixing window by holding down the Shift key on your keyboard, and while holding down the left button on your mouse, drag to create a selection box. This selection box can be adjusted in size and moved, and it can be used to play, copy, cut this area. You can also set a new start and end time of a selection box by positioning the play bar at the point at which you want the selection box to begin. Right click on the selection box and select Snap Start to play cursor. To set a new end time, position your cursor and select Snap End to play cursor. The loop region and selection box are defaulted to snap to the nearest grid line. If you'd like to disable this, click on the Snap to Grid button in the mixing window toolbar. Finally, some of the other features we've included is jump the play bar to the start of the mix, reverse play, which will play your mix in reverse, control the global pan of your mix, the global volume of your mix, and the global video brightness. One final note, you can have multiple mixes open within the mixing window and move between the mixes quickly by clicking on their respective tabs.